Mason, I'm not moving out and running away. I just can't afford this place. Too much money and too many memories.
You knew Dr. Logan well, Miss Wilcox?
Well? All right. I knew him well. Thank you. I illustrated Dr. Logan's book. And that was finished 2 months ago.
Have you seen him since?
No.
Miss Wilcox, there are 10 people in this town who'll swear that you have seen him.
Your neighbors, a lifeguard, a waitress, and a bartender.
Well, well, well. So Van Fowler has himself a good lawyer, huh?
How do you know Van?
I worked with him on Stewart's, Dr. Logan's book. Hyatt Publishing arranged it. I don't know much about him, Mr. Mason. Just that he killed Stewart.
The state has to prove that, Miss Wilcox.
And I'm going to do my best to help. I've already told the district attorney that I'll testify.
About what? Will you testify that Stewart Logan was in this house every weekend for months? Are you going to tell the court that he paid the rent? That he bought the car you're driving?
You make it sound dirty. A kept woman.
Miss Wilcox, I...
It wasn't sordid. And it wasn't ugly.
Wasn't it? Sneaking up here, lying, pinching pennies all week and playing the great lover on weekends. Cheating on his responsibilities to his school, his colleagues, his wife.
He didn't love her.
But he did love you. I suppose that's why he kept his wife in his home and you in a dark closet.
He promised that when his promotion came through, he'd leave that wife of his. Then we could be together no more, furtive hiding, no more lying.
And you believe that?
Yes.
You have a trusting soul, Miss Wilcox.
And you have no soul at all. You've taken something beautiful and made it appear filthy. Now get the blazes out of here.
I'm sorry, Miss Wilcox. I'm sorry for you.
Oh, don't be sorry for me, Mr. Mason. Save your pity for Van Fowler. I'm going to tell everything I know about him. Everything. After an argument with Dr. Logan about one of my technical illustrations, Mr. Fowler said to me, Logan will get himself killed one of these days.
Did you observe any other instances of animosity between the defendant and the decedent during work on the book?
Yes, I recall the day we finished work. Dr. Logan had left. Mr. Fowler read the preface that Dr. Logan had prepared, and then he drew a circle around the pronoun I every time it appeared.
Now, why would he do that?
He was furious. Finally, he got up, and he yelled, I, and then he tore it up and threw the pieces on Dr. Logan's desk.
Would you say, from your experience with him, that it was normal behavior for the defendant to do a thing like that?
Mr. Fowler had a violent temper.
Mr. Mason?
No questions at this time.